Yes, sir. You have audible.
Yes, I think. Can I continue?
Yes, sir.
Any sets kavali?
Okay, okay. మా స్క్రీన్ డిస్ప్లే అవ్వట్లేదు కదా, రావట్లేదు కదా ఇక్కడ.
నో సార్,
ఓకే ఓకే, జస్ట్ ఎ మినిట్. Yes, just give me 1 minute time. I will leave and join. I think there is an issue in screen. Actually, it's not allowing me to share my screen. Please check the settings. Shravan, am I audible?
Yeah, yes, sir. Please check now, sir.
Now it's okay. Now it's okay. Okay.
Yes, sir, we can see your screen now, sir.
Yes, okay. Yes, anyway, let me continue my discussion. I think what we were saying before the break, we were discussing about linear regression, isn't it? Let me continue. This is simple demonstration on linear regression. Actually, just give me 1 minute time. This is lecture number 181. Let me go back. Yes. my dear friends, this is one of the important concept. Actually, if am I audible?
Yes, sir. Yes,
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 sir. Yes,
actually, hello. Yes, amma cheppandi. Yes, I think maybe just try to recall today first session itself. In beginning itself, we discussed regression process. In that regression process, if you recall that flow chart, there is something like goodness of fit. There is something like in that regression process, there is something like after fitting the model, you have to check whether the model is correct model or not. That is known as, the term itself says, goodness of fit. Fit means what? Fitting means, what does it mean? Fitting means identifying function. Otherwise, let me go to just let me take one minute time here. In that regression process flowchart, I request all of you to refer regression process flowchart. In that regression process flowchart, there is something like goodness of fit. I don't know how many of you remember goodness of fit. First, what is fit? You might have seen something like underfitting, isn't it? You might have heard something like overfitting, isn't it? People used to call something like appropriate fit. But if you speak strictly, there is no such standard term. This is standard term. Underfitting is standard term. Overfitting is standard term. There are few people people may define. There are few data scientists. They are defining something like this. What is data science? There may be people who can say it's a game between underfitting and overfitting. Yes. Anyway, in due course of time, we will try to understand what is underfitting, what is overfitting in detailed manner. Now, here I have something like goodness of fit. What is the meaning of goodness of fit? Fit means what? You have a data x comma y, isn't it? X comma y means just x means not only x, x1, x2, x3, so on, xn. Y means just not y, y1. Yes, y2, y means y3, it may take n values, yn, isn't it? That's what it says, x1, y1, x2, y2, something like it. You have a data, by using this data, you identify a relation between y and x. Let me say, you realize that relation is sine, y equals sine x. That's a model. Model means what? Identifying relationship between dependent variable and independent variable. That may be y equal sin x, that may be y equal cos x, that may be y equal to 10x plus 3, isn't it? Y equal to the x square plus 1, that may be relation, isn't it? Is it not? Yes. By using your data, my dear friends, one must remember here, you are always working with sample. This term is important. You are always working with sample. We are not working with population, isn't it? Why you are not working with population? Why? Because it is difficult to work with population as there are time constraint, as are manpower constraint, as financial money constraint, isn't it? That's why in data science, just take any case studies in data science. If you observe any case studies, what data we used to take? We used to take sample data, isn't it? We are working with samples. Yes. Let me say, you have a sample data. You have x1, y1, x2, y2, x3, y3, so on, xn, yn. You identify a relationship, something like y equal to some 5x plus 10, something. Let me assume for simplicity. Yes, I must check how I must check. This is fitting. Fitting means what? Fitting means identifying 5 comma 10. Yes, what is fitting? In between y comma x. If you identify sine, that is fitting. If you identify cos, that is fitting. If you identify 5 comma 10, that is fitting. How far goodness of fit? Goodness of fit means after fitting this model, how far it is good, how well it behaves. That's important, isn't it? Yeah, this data is known as training data. If I speak strictly, I don't want to introduce this term now itself. After fitting the model to how far it correct, that is important. For that, there is something like R squared value. What is this? R squared value, or otherwise people used to say determinant of coefficient. Yes, that is known as R squared value. What is this R squared value? What is this determinant of coefficient? We will try to understand. Just see, for that one, this is related to our goodness of fit in our flowchart. Just say this one, what it says, R squared value definition, there is a one formula, explained variation by total variation. We will try to understand that in little bit in detail manner. Range of R squared value, what is the range? Range says 0% to 100%. Means, for example, sine x range, minus 1 to plus 1, something like that, isn't it? In similar manner, range of R squared, minimum it can take 0, 0% means 0. Maximum 100% means it's a 1. That's a R squared value, minimum value is 0 and maximum value is 1. Isn't it? That's what it says. R squared is goodness of fit measure. Yes, how good it is. You fitted the model, how good it is. Actually, there are other other goodness of fit measures. For example, if you take multilinear regression, there is something like adjusted R squared value. If you take logistic regression, I will spend time on logistic regression and tomorrow I will discuss. There is something like pseudo R squared value, isn't it? Here in this context, it is known as R squared value. What is goodness of fit? We will try to understand. Just see, let me assume I have points here. Let me, actually, this is a slide I collected from one of the NPTEL lecture. I'm explaining same thing here. You have X. Let me say, I already explained what is X, what is Y, what is Y bar. Y bar means means of Y, isn't it? Let me say this one. I request all of you, spend few minutes time on this particular lecture. All data science faculty who are attending this particular session, please spend some time. Yes. This is geometrically what is R squared values. Just try to spend some time. Let me say I have point here, X comma Y. Just see my mouse cursor here, X comma Y. Isn't it? This is the line Y cap equal to B naught plus B1X. There is something like Y means actual value. Isn't it? Just try to recall, my dear friends. Try to recall. We discussed geometrical interpretation of linear regression. Once you, if you understand in geometrical regression of linear regression, I don't know how many of you remember what is error. What we were saying, error means actual value minus predicted value. Just see, this is Y. Y is actual value. Y bar is, what is Y bar? Y cap, predicted value, isn't it? Where is Y? This is my Y. This is Y cap. This difference is known as Y minus Y cap. This is error, isn't it? Sum of squares error. That's why they are calling it is error. SSE, that is SSE. I don't know if you know the ANOVA. There is something like ANOVA. Don't worry about it. If you don't know ANOVA also, it doesn't matter. This is something like SSE. What is SSR? SSR means this is Y cap. This point is Y cap. This point is Y cap. This is Y bar. Y cap minus Y bar. This portion is known as SSR. If this entire portion from here to here, this entire portion is SST, total sum of squares, SST means, isn't it? Just spend a few minutes time on this particular lecture. Even though it takes time, just try to go through this lecture once or twice. Why? Because if you are in machine learning, if you are data science, after fitting the model, you must know how to evaluate how far it is correct model. For this, R squared equal to explained error by total error. That is SSR by SST. Maybe time may not permit me to spend much time, but don't worry about the derivation of R squared. How you got this R squared equal to SSR by SST, don't worry. There are mathematics people, they used to work on it. That's not our duty, isn't it? Of course, if you know the derivation, it's good. But being a data scientist, if you know the formula and if you are able to use it, it's fine. This R squared value, maximum value 1, as a minimum value is 0. That's what we were saying. Just understand this particular geometrical interpretation. Certainly, it will be helpful for you. Just go through it. It's not that great thing. Just see here. If you observe this one, if you, this regression results, there is a slide. I think this slide is not that visible. Don't worry. Here in the slide, I will read. Here you are getting R squared. This is R squared. You are getting 0.877. This number is 0.877. R squared maximum value is 1. R squared minimum value is 0. 0.877 means I can treat it as 87.7. I am approximating 87.7. I can treat it as 88%. That 87.8 can be treated as 87.8 can be treated as 88%. Means what is the maximum value of R squared value? 1. What is the minimum value of R squared value? 0. R squared value 1 means it's perfect model. You got 100 out of 100. Once if you say your R squared value is 1, you have got 100 out of 100. Your R squared value 0.877 means you have got 87.7%. Approximately, your percentage is 88%. Yes, if you get 88%, will you happy? if you get 88%, if you get 88%, will you be happy with that 88%? If you are happy with that score, it's okay, isn't it? That is 87.7 means I can say it is okay. It is 88%. Okay, it is 88% means. What does it mean? You are getting 0.877 means 88% of the variability in the number of cars sold. Yes, what is this number of cars sold? You have two variables, isn't it? Number of cars sold is dependent variable, isn't it? What is number of cars sold? Dependent variable. What is independent variable? TV advertisements is independent variable. Your independent variable is explaining. Which one is explaining? Your independent variable is explaining dependent variable. Which one is independent variable here? Independent variable. What is independent variable here? TV ads. Your independent variable is TV ads. Your TV ads is explaining number of cars sold only 88%. Means number of cars sold is not only depending on TV ads. For example, in previous in morning session we were saying that plant growth and fertilizer is independent variable, plant growth is dependent variable. Plant growth depends on fertilizer, but fertilizer is not only one independent variable. There may be other independent variables like soil, soil moisture level, soil temperature, that may be sun. There are so many factors, isn't it? In similar manner, here that need not be TV advertisement. That may be other factors which may affect car sold. Means you are getting 88% R squared value means you might missing one or more independent variable. Just go back, check the model, identify the variables, or you miss some variables. If they are missing, just try to reformulate the problem, and you have to redo all these things. Of course, in this particular lecture, that's R squared value is also known as coefficient of determination. There is something like correlation coefficient in mathematics. There is a relationship between correlation coefficient and R squared value. Rx comma y is correlation coefficient. Y equal to b0 plus b1x. You are getting 10 plus 5x. What is sine of b1? Sine of b1, b1 means 5. Whose sine is plus? Therefore, is keeping plus under root of R square. R square is adjusted R square value. I am getting 0.877. You will get correlation coefficient. Don't worry about this particular slide. I would like to highlight that there is a relationship between correlation coefficient and R squared value, nothing more than that. This is one of the important lecture one has to understand. Why? Because if you want to understand other concepts like adjusted R square, other concepts like pseudo R squared in the case of logistic regression. While discussing about adjusted R square also, I will come back our adjusted R square value. Actually, adjusted R square value we will discuss in the context of multilinear regression. We will compare that adjusted R square value with R squared value while discussing pseudo R squared value in the case of pseudo R squared value in the case of logistic regression. While discussing pseudo R squared value, also we'll compare that pseudo R squared values with adjusted R square value and R squared value. Again, I will come back to this particular lecture. Maybe in tomorrow's session, I will come back and I will discuss. Actually, we were saying linear regression assumptions about the error term. I don't know how many of you remember. Just in initial slide itself, we were saying that. We were discussing about something, some assumptions about the error term. If I speak strictly, we were saying that every regression model has got some error. Every regression model has got some assumptions. Logistic regression has got some assumption. Linear regression has got some assumption. Support vector machines has got, support vector machine is a model which has got some assumption. assumptions. Naive-Bayes classification is a model which has got some assumptions. K-medoid has got some assumptions. K-means has got some assumptions. Each K-nearest neighborhood algorithm has got some assumptions. Each machine learning algorithm has got some assumptions. These are the assumptions in the context of linear regression. That's what it says. The error E is a random variable with mean of zero. I don't know how many of you remember this. I already explained error E1, X1, Y1 point, you will get error E1. For X2, how will I get for X1, Y1 point error E1? E1 is Y1 minus Y1 cap. E2 is Y2 minus Y2 cap. E3 is Y3 minus Y3 cap. En is Yn minus Yn cap. I will get n errors, error 1, error 2, so on, error 3, error n, isn't it? Your error means basically a number. If there are n data points, let me go back to the slide once. Let me explain, just see. Now, what it says, let me say I have these data points. Let me say I have these data points. Let it be like this. Just see this one. This is X1, Y1. This is my first data point. X2, Y2. So on. Let me say I have data points X and Yn. Let me say error Y1. What is my error Y1? Y1 minus Y1 cap. What is my error 2? Y2 minus Y2 cap. What is my error 3? Y3 minus Y3 cap. So on, what is my error n? Yn minus Yn cap, isn't it? Yes, this errors, I have error terms. E1, E2, so on. E1, E2, E3, so on. I have n error terms. N error terms, isn't it? Basically, what is this E1? It's a number. It's a number. What is E2? This is also a number. What is E3? This is also a number. What is En? This is also a number. I have how many numbers are there? I have n numbers. I have n errors for each. Of course, in these errors, some errors may be zero. For example, if that particular data point is in the regression line itself, that error is zero, isn't it? Basically, I would like to highlight that there are n error points, otherwise not points, it's a numbers. There are n error numbers. What was the assumption in the context of linear regression? The error is a random variable with mean of zero. Once if you have errors E1, E2, En, can you find mean of it? E1 plus E2 plus so on En by N, that mean is zero. That is the assumption. My dear friends, I have to validate the assumption. There is some sort of theoretical background behind these assumptions. I can always, I don't know how many of you remember, how can I validate assumptions? There is something like, I can validate two things. If you go to the, if you go to that regression process, you have to validate two things, isn't it? Which one you have to validate? Which one you have to validate? You have to validate two things. Which one? You have to validate. We have to validate assumption. Just refer regression process flowchart. You have to validate assumptions. That is one thing. Also, you have to validate after assumptions. You have to validate the model. How can I validate the regression linear model? By R squared value. It is R squared value or coefficient of determination. This we discussed just in previous lecture. This we already discussed. What about this? Validating assumptions. I can validate assumption by using residual plots. There is something like residual plot. Example, what is the example? One example of assumption, mean of the errors in linear regression equals zero. I have n errors, E1, E2, plus so on, En will be equal to zero. That's what it says, mean of this assumption. I can validate these assumptions by using residual plots, isn't it? That's what it says. Yes, there is something like, if you know error, You can always identify error square. Then, my dear friends, I request all of you, by next class, this term, just read this term, sedasticity. Just check whether my pronunciation is correct or not. What is this? Homoscedasticity. This is one of the important terms in regression. Just refer what is homoscedasticity. Just refer and remind me in next session. That is in tomorrow's session. That term itself says homo means same. What is homoscedasticity? Homoscedasticity. I may be wrong in pronunciation. Homoscedasticity. Yes, this is HOMOSCEDASTICITY. Homoscedasticity. Okay. What is it? The variance of E denoted by E square, isn't it? Generally, variance means sigma square. People used to represent as sigma square, isn't it? Variance of E is denoted by E square. It's the same for all values of the independent variables. If I calculate, can I calculate E? I can calculate E. My dear friends, this is important. Are we calculating errors for dependent variable or independent variable? Just try to recall formula for error. What is error? Yi minus yi cap. Yi minus yi cap. What is y? Y is dependent variable. That's what it says. Error is in terms of dependent variable. Just see, the variance of E means error term, denoted by E. Actually, variance of E is E. Variance of E denoted by E square. E square is variance of the error term, is the same for all the values of the independent variables. If there are n independent variables, y1, y2, so on, yn, isn't it? You can calculate error means for different independent variables, you will get dependent variables, isn't it? Yes, if I keep x1, you will get y1. If you keep x2, you will get y2. If you keep xn, you will get yn. Anyway, don't worry about this particular statement. Just refer dictionary meaning of this particular homoscedasticity, and also refer meaning of homoscedasticity in the context of linear regression, so that read then this particular assumption, you can understand. Just remind me next session what is this. Also, we will discuss the values of E are independent. What does it mean? Values of E means what? My dear friends, all these are assumptions of linear regression. My third assumption is the values of E are independent. E means what? Error. How many error values I will get? N error values. How can I get N error values? There are N points. X1, Y1, my first point. X2, Y2 is my second point. Xn, Yn is my third. X1, Y1, X2, Y2, X3, Y3, so on. Xn, Yn, isn't it? There are N points. And the values of E are independent. E1, E2, E3, so on. Error 1, error 2, error 3, error N. The values are independent. E1, E2, so on. En, E1, E2, so on. En are independent. Isn't it? Independent means what? For X, comma Y, you will get error. Isn't it? For each X, comma Y, I will get error. I will plot them. If you plot, the independent means that will not be in any, that will not show any pattern, isn't it? Of course, we can discuss about there is something like testing for significance in the context of what it says. He is writing y equal to b0 plus b1x. What is this b0 and b1x? Actually, which one is important in b0 and b1x? People used to write in two ways. One is y cap equal to b0 plus b1x. There is another one is beta naught plus beta 1x. Actually, what is the difference? Generally, people used to write this beta naught plus beta 1x is it in population model. This is known as population model. This is known as sample model. B0, b1x is known as sample model. We used to take sample data and we have to make interpretations on population model. Yes, we work with sample model. We will find b0 b1 using sample model, and we will make interpretation on population model on beta net and beta 1. We are actually, this is something like we discussed assumptions of linear regression. Now we are discussing testing for significance. This testing for significance in your BTech days, you might have learned and statistics. There is something like null hypothesis and alternative hypothesis. Actually, it is useful for finding a significant regression relationship between dependent variable and dependent variable and independent variable, isn't it? That is why it's called beta naught plus beta 1x. Actually, my dear friends, there are testing for significance, there are two tests. One is t-test and f-test. When can we use t-test? When can we use f-test? Time being, just understand. These two tests are useful for testing for significance, testing of significance relationship between dependent and independent variables. If you have more independent variable, generally we use f-test. For the less independent variable t-test. Of course, there are different interpretations. Generally, if you have mean, we use t-test. If you have variance sort of things, we use f-test. Don't worry about these things. I will discuss in detail manner about these tests. Time being, just understand this t-test and f-test are useful in testing for significance in the context of linear regression. This is about this particular lecture says. Let me go back to this particular lecture. This is linear regression. How can I do hypothesis testing in the context of linear regression? We will try to understand. Just see this one. This is simple and straightforward. I have two models. One model is y equal to b0 plus b1x. That is sample level. Y equal to beta naught plus beta 1x. That is population. Actually, I have to check how significant it is in population level. My dear friends, in y equal to beta naught plus beta 1x, which one is important one, which actually decides a significant relationship, which actually, for example, if I say beta 1 equals 0, what happens? If I say beta 1 equals 0, you will get y equal to beta naught, isn't it? Otherwise, let me take y equal to, just let me go to the slide, slide 1 second. Let me say like this. Let me say I have an equation. I have y equal to beta naught plus beta 1x. Yes, what is this? Y equal to beta naught plus beta 1x. This is important. This is very important, isn't it? For example, let me say beta 1 equal to 0. What will you get? You will get y equal to beta naught. Y equal to constant. Y equal to constant. This is y equal to beta naught line. This is beta naught. Y equal to constant means a line parallel to x-axis. For all values of x, you will get this only. What does it mean? For all values of x, if you get only this, what does it mean? There is no relationship. There is no significant relationship between x and y. If beta 1 equals 0, this will be converted as y equal to beta naught. In y equal to beta naught, whichever x you will give, you will get only y beta naught. Means you will get a straight line like this. There is no significant relationship between x and y. That's what it says. Generally, there is something like null hypothesis. There is something like alternative hypothesis. Null hypothesis means people used to treat it as hypothesis of no difference. What is this? Hypothesis of no difference. Hypothesis of no difference means there is no relationship between x and y. That is hypothesis of no difference. Means in the context of null hypothesis, we used to assume beta 1 equals 0. In the context of alternative hypothesis, it is also denoted as H1 in the context of H1, we used to assume this is beta 1 not equal 0. That's what he is explaining here. It's nothing more than that. Just see, just let me go back to this particular video. Actually, what it says here, it says beta 1 equal 0 is null hypothesis, beta 1 not equal 0 is alternative hypothesis. What is my t-test? T-test is b1 minus beta 1 by sb1. Actually, what is, we are assuming H0 is true. We are assuming H0 is true means null hypothesis is true. This beta 1 equal 0. B1 by, you will get P1 by SB1. What is my B1? You know B1. What is my B1? Y equal to beta naught plus beta 1x. B1 is coefficient of x. Of course, here beta 1, as we are assuming 0, B1 minus beta 1 is 0. SB1, of course, that SB1 I will explain. Just let me go to this particular actually test of significance sort of things. What it says, actually you can do this test of significance in different ways. Why we have to do test of significance? In order to identify whether there is a significant relation between X and Y. That's the idea. My dear friends, this particular OLS regression results is important. In just see here, R squared value 0.887, same for adjusted R squared value 0.836, F statistic 21.43, probability of F statistics 0.0190, log likelihood minus 9.6687, AIC 23.3. My dear friends, those people who are really interested in data science, those people who are really want to make some difference in data science, please understand, at least just see here, dependent variable. What is dependent variable? Coarse-fold. What is the model name? Ordinary least square model. Method, least square method, isn't it? Date, September 5, Saturday, 05, September 2020. Time, 23. Number of observation. Just go through that data set. You have 5 observations. TV ads and car sales. There are 5 observations. Degree of freedom, residuals. I will discuss this one. Yes, model, these things I will discuss. Covariance type, non-robot, these things I will discuss. Just see. Yes, for example, Durbin-Watson, kurtosis, I will discuss. Q, I will discuss. Omnibus, just for example, AIC, BIC. I may not able to discuss what is AIC, but I will discuss log likelihood. I will discuss this probability. I will discuss F statistics. I will discuss adjusted R square value. I will discuss R square value. I will discuss standard error. Yes, anyway, SB1. Here you are saying SB1 means standard error. S means standard error. Yes. Yes. A few important things I will discuss here, but I request all of you, even if I not discuss few things, you need not understand. Just at least understand what is the abbreviation of AIC. If possible, try to understand definition. What is abbreviation of BIC? What it indicate? Just try to understand these indicators meaning. That's more than enough, isn't it? Yes. Anyway, here what it says here, why as null hypothesis, refer lecture number 179. In that particular lecture only we assumed this beta 1 equals 0. Actually, in initial days of recording these lectures, someone who gone through my lecture, he suggested me, better you keep lecture numbers. In initial days, I was not keeping lecture number. Just I used to keep record lectures and just I keep to upload. But one person suggested me in that comment section, keep lecture numbers. I didn't remember his name. I must be thankful to him. He only suggested, as I didn't remember his name also. I must thankful to him. As per his suggestion only, from that day onwards, I gave lecture number so that it is convenient for me to refer previous lecture. This is a lecture number 179, where we discussed this about this particular data set. This is B1 by SP1. What is B1? This is constant is 10. This I already discussed. This is B1. B1 means what? 5. 5 means TV ads, isn't it? This is something like Y equal to 10 plus 5 into TV ads. Otherwise, car sold equal to 10 plus 5 into TV ads, something like this. B1 is this TV ads. It's a coefficient of independent variable is B1. SB1, What is a standard error? Just see here, STD error. That is 1.080. That is T. You are getting T. This is T value. Actually, my T value is actually, if I speak strictly, if I speak strictly, there are two things. There is something like one tail test, two. I can say right tail test, left tail test, two tail test. Actually, in null hypothesis, we are keeping beta one equal zero. In alternative hypothesis, I am saying beta one not equal zero. Anyway, I will spend some time on hypothesis testing. If possible, just go through. If I say not equal zero, it is two tail test. In the for Navy people, if someone is miss that probability link, don't worry about this. Why am I using alpha? Alpha means known as level of significance. Just try to recall your BTEC days. For BTEC exam, you might have taken this particular. Level of significance. Level of significance is alpha by 2. Why I'm taking alpha by 2? By default, alpha value is 5%. Alpha by 2 means 0.05 by 2. That is 0.025. As beta 1 not equal to 0, I'm taking a two-tail test. Just try to recall your engineering days. For you in engineering days, you might have taken this particular T distribution, normal distribution values to your examination. Otherwise, your examination branch might have supplied you. This is number of degrees of freedom, n minus 2. There are 5 observations minus 2, 3 degrees of freedom. This is new, 3 degrees of freedom. Alpha by 2 is 0.025. This value, it's saying 3.182. This is tabulated value, isn't it? Or what is your calculated value? 4.83. If your calculated value is bigger than tabulated value, you have to reject null hypothesis. Rejecting null hypothesis means a null hypothesis is beta 1 equal 0. Rejecting beta 1 equal 0 means beta 1 not equal 0. Beta 1 not equal 0 means there is a significant relationship between cars sold. There is a significant relationship between cars sold and TVI. This is one way of doing hypothesis testing for linear regression. There is another way that is known as p-value approach. P means probability. Just see, probability of F statistic 0.0190, alpha, we are assuming alpha equal 0.05, p is less than or equal, reject null hypothesis. If p is less than or equal to alpha, yes, 0.019 is less than or equal to 0.05, reject h naught means beta 1 equal 0 is reject, that is beta 1 not equal 0. My dear friends, this is p value approach. Earlier I discussed t value approach. This is p value approach. There is something like confidence interval approach. You have to calculate confidence interval. You might have calculated confidence interval in your BTEC days. Just try to recall how to calculate. There is one simple formula for calculating confidence interval. What is that formula? Let me show that formula here. I have this formula is, what is this? B1, just see here, B1 plus R minus, there is some simple formula. What is that formula? Just let me show that formula. Once if you 95, generally we used to find 95% confidence interval. That is simple calculation. What is my beta 1? Beta 1, what is null hypothesis assumption? Beta 1 equals 0. That beta 1 is in confidence interval. Accept null hypothesis. Beta 1 is not in confidence interval. Reject null hypothesis. My dear friend, this is third approach. First approach is t-test. Second approach is p-value approach. Third approach is, if your beta 1 is in confidence interval, accept null hypothesis. Otherwise, reject null hypothesis. How can I calculate confidence interval? Just see here, I calculated. It is simple and straightforward. B1 plus or minus T alpha by 2 into SB1. B1, you know, TVAT's coefficient, that is independent variable coefficient B1, 5 plus or minus T alpha by 2. Just I have shown in table. You might have taken that table into your BTEC exams. T alpha by 2 is also, we discussed. SB1 I also discussed. What is SB1? 1.080, 5 plus or minus. You have got lower limit, upper limit. Your beta 1 equals 0. If the 0 is inside, accept null hypothesis. If it is not inside, of course, 0 is not in between 1.56 and 8.44. I have to reject null hypothesis. This third approach. Therefore, beta 1 not equal 0 is correct. Isn't it? There are different ways. Even you can check. get with the help of F statistics. There is a formula, F statistics, MSR by MSC. Don't worry about that formula. Actually, F statistics, you can directly calculate this OLS regression result. What is my F statistic value? 21.43. Again, you have to go to your BTEC days. In BTEC days, you might have taken your, this is something like K by N minus K minus 1. What is my K? K is number of independent variables. How many number of independent variables you have? You have only one independent variable, that is TVRs. If it is multiple linear regression, you can have multiple independent variables. Here you have only one independent variable. Number of independent variable is 1, k equal to 1. That is 1 by n is number of observations, total number of observations, 5 observations. 5 minus k is 1, 5 minus 1 minus 1, 5 minus 2, 5 minus 2 means 3. Numerator 1, denominator 3. This is 1 degrees of freedom. This is 3D. This is known as nu 1, nu 1 equal to 1, nu 2 equal to 3. Yeah, again, at what level of significance we are discussing? 5% of level of 5% of level of significance. Again, go to BTEC days. In BTEC days, you might have seen this table. You might have taken to your BTEC examination. This is 0.05 level of significance as by default value of alpha is 0.05. Nu 1 comma nu 2. What is my nu 1 value? What is my nu 2 value? Nu 1 value is 1. Nu 2 value is 3. That is 10 point. I think you are getting some 10.13. 10.13. This is tabulated value. I must calculate this tabulated value with calculated value. My calculated value is what is 21.43. This is the calculated value. Tabulated value is 10.13 is tabulated value. BTEC tables. Let me say, I should not say BTEC table for understanding. Just I'm saying BTEC table. If it is a case, reject H naught. Rejecting H naught means beta 1 naught equals 0. Means there are different ways. Just understand different ways. Try to recall. We discussed about t-test, we discussed about f-test, we discussed about confidence interval approach. Now we discussed about f-test. Just I am defining AIC, just I am abbreviation, just I am giving abbreviations, nothing more than that. Maybe actually it's almost 12:57. Let me conclude this session. I will continue my discussion. Basically, in my next lecture, what I will do? I will spend some time on linear regression. Something like I will discuss about adjusted R square value. I will discuss multiple linear regression. I will discuss about adjusted R square value. I will also discuss about relation between R squared value and adjusted R square value. I may spend a little bit time, maybe initial 10 to 15 minutes. After that, I will discuss logistic regression and its performance analysis. There we will discuss about pseudo R squared value. Let me conclude this session here itself. Yes, my dear coordinators, actually, if there is any queries, we will discuss as many of faculties from this college. At least I can see my department people. I'm happy to see all of you here. Yes, if there is any. Yes. Yes, my dear coordinators.
Thank you very much, sir, for sincerely and honestly delivering the lecture. We could see your passion. And also, just for the information, sir has been showing some of the videos from his own channel, Rajshekhar Sir Classes. There are almost more than 1,000 lectures available online. And we appreciate you, sir, for emphasizing on the fundamentals, which are foundations. Thank you very much, sir. And I think the first time listeners are definitely benefited, and also second or third time listeners also, we are so thankful to you, sir. And let us not forget that sir has asked us to just go through what is homocedasticity, AIC and BIC. And it would be really great if we could revise what has been already taught today in those two sessions. And before winding up, I request all the participants to please switch on your videos so that the coordinator wants to take a snap of all our beautiful faces. Yeah, please stay switched on for a few seconds. Once I get confirmation from the coordinator, you can switch off again.